This is where we stopped. Please see this as a continuum. Okay, let's do the math. So what's going to happen is this. The air is going to rise from zero sea level up to 6,000 feet. How many thousands of feet is that air moving up from zero to 6,000 feet? Answer is 6,000 feet. What we're going to do is we're going to multiply the DAR, the dry adiabatic rate, which is 5.5 degrees Fahrenheit per 1,000 feet, times 6, because the formula is already in thousands. This is 5.5 degrees times 6. 5.5 times 6 is 33. Is it 33 degrees hotter or colder up there at 6,000 feet on the windward side? The answer is colder. So we subtract 72, which was the given at sea level. That was what the air mass started at. 72 minus 33 is 39. This tells us that the air temperature at the condensation level at 6,000 feet is 39 degrees. Good. Let's do the next one. Now the air is going to rise from 6,000 up to 11,000 feet. How many thousands of feet is that air parcel rising from 6,000 up to 11,000? The answer is 5,000 feet. We are now going to take the WAR, since the relative humidity is 100% throughout that entire expanse from 6,000 to 11,000, the WAR, which is 3.3 degrees Fahrenheit per 1,000 feet, and multiply that by 5 for 5,000 feet, the difference between 6,000 and 11,000. 3.3 times 5 is 16.5. It's obviously colder up there. So we're going to take 39, which is what the temperature was at 6,000 feet, minus 16.5 degrees equals 22.5 degrees. Now we know the temperature at the top of the mountain at 11,000 feet is 22.5 degrees. Now the air is going to descend the leeward side of the mountain. The air is going to drop down from 11,000 feet to 3,000 feet, that inland leeward side valley. How many thousands of feet is the air descending from 11,000 down to 3,000 feet? Answer is 8,000. And every time the air descends, we use the DAR, 5.5 degrees Fahrenheit per 1,000 feet. Therefore, we're going to take 5.5 times 8 for 8,000 feet. 11,000 to 3,000 is 8,000, which is 44. However, the air is warming up. Because of that, we're not going to subtract, we're going to add. We take 22.5 degrees, which was the temperature at the top of the mountain at 11,000 feet, plus 44, which is the temperature that the air is warmed up en route to that 3,000 foot valley, is 66.5 degrees. So the temperature at 3,000 feet in the leeward side valley is 66.5 degrees. Now we have all the math on here. Good. Here's what you should be able to discern, though. There's a little more. You should be able to tell me what the relative humidity is at 6,000 feet on the windward side, what the relative humidity is at 11,000 feet at the top of the mountain, what the relative humidity is at 8,221 feet and 6¾ inches on the windward side, what the dew point temperature is at 6,000 feet on the windward side, what the dew point temperature is at 11,000 feet, where the relative humidity is higher, 8,000 feet on the leeward side or 6,000 feet on the leeward side, and why.